my fortress I stand firm. I've no fear of the night and its shadow. I've no fear of the plague that runs around. For your light shines, O Lord, in the darkness, and your brightness leads me on. In the Lord is my home. In the Lord is my help. He's my shield and my strength. He's my fortress. I stand firm.
My dear brothers and sisters, this Mass is offered for the following intentions: for the soul of Angela Lawson, for the soul of Echidia Rodericks, for the intentions of the parishioners, and for box intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of Lord Jesus Christ and love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with your spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, our God is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the creator of heaven and earth. He is the hallmark of love, mercy and compassion. For times we have failed to prove ourselves as the beacons of compassion. Let us pause and ask pardon from our Heavenly Father. Together, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, O Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, O Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us.
Let us glorify God by singing the Gloria.
God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of God.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. The Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading is taken from the prophet Isaiah. Say to those who have an anxious heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears the deaf unstopped. Then shall the lame man leap like a deer, and the tongue of the mute sing for joy. For waters break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response to the Psalms will be as follows. My soul, give praise to the Lord.
My soul, give praise to the Lord.
All together.
My soul, give praise to the Lord.
It is the Lord who preserves fidelity forever, who does justice to those who are oppressed. It is He who gives bread to the hungry, and the Lord sets the prisoners free. Our response.
My soul give praise to the Lord.
The Lord will open the eyes of the blind, and the Lord will raise up those who are bowed down. It is the Lord who loves the just, the Lord who protects the strangers. Our response.
My soul give praise to the Lord.
The Lord upholds the orphan and the widow, but towards the path of the wicked. Lord will reign forever, the God of Zion, from age to age. Our response.
My soul give praise to the Lord.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of Saint James. My brothers, show no partiality as you hold the faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory. For if a man wearing a gold ring and fine clothing comes into your assembly, and a poor man in shabby clothing also comes in, and if you pay attention to the one who wears the fine clothing and say, you sit here in a good place, while you say to the poor man, you stand over there, or sit down at my feet. Have you not then made distinction among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my beloved brothers, has not God chosen those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom which He has promised to those who love him the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus was proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every affliction among the people.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus returned from the region of Tyre and went through the Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, the region of the Decapolis. And they brought to him a man was deaf and had a speech impediment, and they begged him to lay his hand on him. And taking him aside from the crowd privately, he put his fingers into his ears and after spitting touched his tongue, and looking up to heaven he sighed and said to him, Ephphatha, that is, be opened. And his ears were opened, his tongue was released, and he spoke plainly. And Jesus charged them to tell no one, but the more he charged them, the more zealously they proclaimed it. And they were astonished beyond measure, saying, He has done all things well. He even makes the deaf hear, the mute speak. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, Saint Teresa of Calcutta was born in Albania. At a tender age of 8 years, she lost her beloved father. As a result, the family had to face financial crisis. However, this did not stop Saint Teresa from her goal to devote herself to religious life. At the age of 18 years, she joined the Sisters of the Loreto. As a part of mission, she came to India and worked as a teacher in a school near her convent. She was deeply shaken by the suffering and the poverty of the people when Bengal was struck by a severe famine. Later, Saint Teresa experienced the call within a call and decided to dedicate her life to the selfless service of the poor and the needy. It is amazing to see that even though Saint Teresa has left for the heavenly abode, yet thousands and thousands of people till date have benefited through our extraordinary missionary work. Yes, my dear friends, Saint Teresa of Calcutta is a beacon of compassion to the entire humanity. Likewise, today's gospel reading also highlights the compassionate nature of our Lord Jesus Christ. He encountered a man who was deaf and also had an impediment in his speech. It were his friends who brought him to Jesus. You see the sensitive nature of Jesus. He took the man apart in order to cure him. We see the gentleness of Jesus in dealing with the man in a very personal and caring way. He did not treat him as a stranger or a patient, but he treated him as another human being with utmost love and care. My dear friends, in this digital world, we need to be extra cautious sometimes when we achieve success in our so-called vocation, profession, or occupation. Sometimes this extreme success achievement in our respective fields can make us deaf to the voice of God. Furthermore, our craving for name, fame, muscle power, and money can take us to another extreme. It can make us to think that we are superior while the other is inferior. We may believe that we are on cloud 9 and we do not require anyone's help. This attitude can also make us insensitive to the cries of the poor and needy brethren. Besides this, we also need to make a note that sometimes constant failure or pain in our personal and family life can make us deaf to the voice of God. There are possibilities when we are facing a stormy situation. Our focus is mostly on our personal power rather than the power of God. Our concentration is more on the problem rather than the solution. We ignore the sufferings of our fellow brethren. We wonder whether God is present or has He abandoned us. In the bargain, sometimes we land up cursing God, abandon the church, or compromise with the commandments of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the current scenario, many of us find ourselves difficult to pray. The reason is we are satisfied with the basic knowledge about the church that has been imparted during our catechism class. We don't desire to enhance our spiritual knowledge through the family catechesis or frequent reading of the Word of God. It is sad to see that we have expertise in our respective fields, but we are basically illiterate in the matters of faith. We are reluctant or afraid to speak about the atrocities against our Catholic community or to proclaim the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ to our fellow brethren. Therefore, can we seek out for Jesus our Lord by spending more time in prayer? Our deep intimacy with the Lord through our personal prayer, family prayer, frequent reading of the Word of God and the reception of the sacraments will help us to open our ears and to listen to the voice of God. It will help us to loosen our tongues to proclaim the truth and be more compassionate. My dear friends, we need to remember that there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. Our Almighty God is always willing to heal us spiritually, physically, emotionally, and psychologically. He is waiting to empower us with His grace so that we may be more loving, caring, forgiving, and compassionate towards one another. Therefore, as mature Catholics, let us allow Jesus, our Lord, to heal us, that we may have a compassionate heart to hear the cries of the poor and the needy, and become the voice of the voiceless, helpless, downtrodden, and the unwanted who are rejected by the society. My dear friends, Saint Teresa of Calcutta said, "We do not need bombs and guns to bring peace, but we need love and compassion." My dear friends, as we have gathered here to partake in the Eucharistic meal, let us pray that we may have the grace to become the beacons of compassion. Amen.
Together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, for all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, Jesus healed a deaf and dumb man by crying out, "Ephphatha," which means "be opened." That we too may approach the Lord and be opened to the voice of God and the realities around us. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer. Kindly repeat,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Pope, bishops, priests and religious, that as leaders in the Church, they may be attentive to the needs of the people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, that we may refrain from discriminating one another on the basis of color, language and culture. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for all the differently abled persons, especially the blind, deaf and dumb, that they may be shown respect and opportunities for education and employment may be provided to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all teachers, retired and active, who play an important role in molding the lives of our children, that the Lord may bless them and strengthen their vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us participating in this Eucharistic celebration, that nourished by the Word of God, we may become more compassionate towards our fellow brethren. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Kindly pray for your personal and needs of the community. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. Give us the grace to respect and appreciate the dignity of every person. We make this prayer to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours are acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, give us the gift of true prayer and of peace. Graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son. By whose obedience you have been restored those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, to all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks as an exaltation, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh,
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, the supper ended. He took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again, until you come again. You come again.
Therefore, Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Paul and with all your saints, whose constant intercession we present as we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Oswald Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours ever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and from my divine teaching today to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, free from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, with your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look down on our sins with the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My spiritual communion. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My dear friends, be it known to all who are present here that the following couple intends to join in the holy sacrament of matrimony. Ferron Philip Fernandez, bachelor son of Francisco Xavier and Felcy, residing at Nakshatra Cooperating Housing Society, Parel Village. And Avril Rodericks, spinster daughter of Bonnie and Lena Rodericks, residing at Al Mankhul, Dubai, UAE. In case you have any canonical reasons that why this couple cannot join in the holy sacrament of matrimony, you are bound in conscience to inform the parish fathers as soon as possible. Thank you.
Notices for the week. The parish fathers wish all the teachers of our parish a happy Teachers' Day. Last Sunday's collection amounted to ₹18,090. We thank you for your generosity and God bless you.
Please join your hands and bow your heads for God's blessings. The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus is the joy of living. He's the King of life to me. Unto Him I all am given.
Jesus is the joy of living. He's the dearest friend I know. Jesus is the joy of living. He's the dearest.